Hey everybody, Brian Collins here with Digital Tutors, and we ran into Tina with Black Magic Design. She's going to tell us about all the great announcements that Black Magic Design is making here at NAB. How are you doing today, Tina?
I'm great, thank you so much.
So you guys have just basically taken over.
Yes, that's our ultimate plan, to take over the world and conquer. No, of course not. We actually, we've got so many announcements this year. It's been so exciting. 18 new products, 38 new prices on our price sheet. So lots to offer customers and get excited.
And one of the biggest announcements had to do with DaVinci Resolve, right?
Yes. We've had the application under our umbrella for about 5 years now, and I think this has actually been the biggest release that we've done to the application.
Wow.
80 new features, a lot of which focus on editing actually, as well as some other overall features as well.
Great. And also, I guess one of the bigger announcements was this new line of cameras, right?
Yes.
Some replacing others or some adding on. You've gotten smaller with some mini cameras, right?
Right. Yeah. So we have mini and micro cameras. We actually added 3 brand new cameras. We updated sensors to existing Ursa and offer multiple choices on the Ursa Mini for sensor purposes. We've even added accessories. So I think this is the first year we've actually got different accessory options for various cameras. And then we have 2 micro cameras that you can see flying in the front of the quadcopters out there and can be placed in multiple places. So just lots of options no matter what type of shoot you're doing.
And the upgrades for the sensor was the 4.6K, right?
Correct.
Yes,
correct.
Right. And how are people reacting overall? How's walking around the booth? There's always a gaggle of people there looking at
yes.
these beautiful cameras
yes.
as if they're under glass like they're a work of art.
Oh, well, actually it's funny you say that because we have won design awards for some of the cameras that are under glass up there. The Red Dot Award in Australia last year for the cinema camera design. So yeah, it's actually something we pride ourselves on, I believe, is the designs overall. It's we take it very seriously, but we have been so fortunate to have a ton of people come visit us, existing customers as well as new customers looking for different, what our offerings are this year. And the enthusiasm has been overwhelming, and we're just feel very, very fortunate.
So tell us some specifics on the new DaVinci Resolve update.
Sure. So we've done everything from small features like finite details up to like more major features. So if we start with something like the UI, for example, we've actually brightened the UI, which sounds a little crazy because we've always had this dark UI. But when you've got dark UI versus bright video in your face, that can get kind of wearing. So we've brightened it to give you a more even brightness so that your eyes don't fatigue quite as fast. Cleaned up the fonts, made it more user-friendly, essentially, for those people that are looking at the UI for hours and hours. So something that people often overlook, but is obviously important to us. In addition, we've added a ton of editing features. So things that editors need and expect, like multicam editing, is now in here. And it's an elegant reiteration of how that works. And it's, smooth, clean. I think they'll feel very comfortable with that as well. In addition to that, we've added a bunch of audio. So VST and AU plugins, as well as being able to export to Pro Tools. So if you want to export your AAF file, you get your flattened video file. It makes round tripping a lot easier to finish your audio in Pro Tools if you choose to do that path as well. Media management. Huge thing that every editor needs to be able to find your clips, right? You've sometimes got so much content. So we have smart bins, we have keyword searches, and it just makes it so much easier to manage all of that content and then relocate it later, including relink it. So if you move your content and you've lost track of where it is, you find kind of the subdirectory and it automatically will relink a whole bunch of your media for you, which makes time saving, huge time savings. Nested timelines. Another kind of little tweak. We've got things like color match to be able to match one shot, like a foreground to a background, or one shot to a whole group of clips, real quick match to this shot and the rest of them get blended in to start, kind of give you a heads up on your coloring is right off the bat. And then from the editing side, we have a 3D perspective tracker. So if you ever do tracking, you draw, your path, maybe you're doing it for color where you're just going to adjust a certain area, or perhaps, for whatever your edit is, very easy, draw your Bezier path. I'm sure you've seen it where the tracker loses track and kind of skews and runs away. It's a checkbox, and it will actually lock it to your track, and it understands that something may interrupt, but it kind of just keeps all the data points in check, and it's just a really simple fix. on our side, not for the engineers, I'm sure, but it's rock solid. It looks awesome. Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. And then if you are a keying, if you need to do chroma key, we've added a update on the chroma keyer. It's like a swipe of the green screen, a swipe of, you know, this a consistent color. It adds to the mat, some tools to finite and get those blacks and whites on the mat nice and clean, and some spill suppression as well. So really easy to pull a key. If you need to motion track the handles around the outside to get the rest of the image perfect, you can combine it with the 3D tracker. And really easy to get a nice clean key with the new features. And
man, those sound great.
Yeah.
Those are a lot of great updates. Now also, there's been some changes in Fusion, some major changes,
right? So Fusion we purchased back in September, you may recall. And you know, we haven't had a chance to do everything to the application, of course, because it's still relatively new to Blackmagic. But we are demonstrating it. When we bought it, it was Windows only. We're demonstrating it today on the booth as a Mac product, which is awesome. So, did that cut? Somebody just totally walked through the frame. Okay, so just go back to Fusion. Okay. Okay, okay. Okay, sorry. I just all of a sudden I'm like, oh, we're screwed. Okay, don't use that part. So we're demoing the product now on the booth as a Mac product, and have plans in September to have Mac, Windows, and Linux, so we can accommodate all those workflows. In addition, you know, polishing the UI. I'm sure there'll be some other little tidbits in there, but in Q3 you can look for a new set of features from Blackmagic's Fusion.
Well, great. Well, all that sounds wonderful. Well, thanks for taking time to talk to us today.
Thank you so much. Thank you.